In a debate with John Polkinghorne, the physicist Stephen Weinberg has set his argument for the non-existence of God. This is based on the claim that the notion of God does not explain anything in nature. However, Weinberg suggests that his argument can be falsified if a fiery sword will come from nowhere and chops his head. This implies that Professor Weinberg can see the necessity for God only if the universe is run miraculously. A miraculous universe is described by the absence of any order or law that can explain it. Such a universe will need no creator or a sustainer, since it will be completely chaotic, and this is what usually one would expect out of the blind nature. The problem with non-believers from the physics community is that they would like to see God stemming out of one of their equations explaining the masses of the elementary particles. Only then they would believe in God, perhaps. This is why they call the Higgs bosons God's particles. The counter-argument for a chaotic ruling of the universe will be to say that an ordered universe ruled by well-defined laws that do not necessarily lead to fully deterministic results is what necessitates God to exist. This is because we need to have an operator for the laws of nature, and we need an algorithm by which the action of these laws is so coordinated as to achieve fruitful results. Otherwise, the action of the laws of nature cannot be explained. An operator of the laws of nature cannot be an element belonging to the same set, for if so being, such an operator has to abide by the same laws, thus cannot be a ruler. This understanding of the divine agency rules out the notion of the God of the gaps, which is a famous blame for the apologetic argument for the role of divine action in nature. One might describe the laws of nature by saying that these are mathematical expressions that describe natural phenomena. But this definition is not accurate enough, since it is known that mathematical expressions are our own imagination and are artifacts of our logic. Instead, perhaps a more accurate description of the laws of nature would be that they are the events or the phenomenon taking place according to certain algorithms that we can understand logically. The description of these laws in the language of mathematics is called laws of physics. So it should be clear that what is meant by a law of nature is the natural phenomena itself. Whereas the mathematical description is what we can call a law of physics. This distinction between the laws of nature and the laws of physics is necessary to differentiate between ontological objects and epistemological idioms. Furthermore, I can say that such a distinction becomes necessary after we have realized that the description we devise for the laws of nature can be changed due to development of science. For example, Newton's law of gravity is different from Einstein's law of gravity, despite the fact that these are describing the same phenomena. Gravity is a law of nature, but Newton's gravity and Einstein's gravity are two different laws of physics. Defined as such, we can say that the laws of nature are ontology and the laws of physics are epistemology. Measurements of physical properties is an ontological operation. So when we discover the measurements, when we discover that measurements are indeterministic, then we can say that the laws of nature are therefore indeterministic. On the other hand, most of the laws of physics are deterministic. An example is the Schrödinger equation, which is known to be deterministic, while observables contained in the Schrödinger equation are indeterministic. For something to be indeterministic means that there is some kind of a democracy in acquiring the values at that moment. This is what we call acquiring such a value and not any other value should be done in accordance with certain rules, or otherwise nature will be completely chaotic. Chaos may underlay the nature of the physical world, but the fact that the measured values of physical observables are centered around an average, that is what we call the expectation value, suggests that the allowed values are some fluctuations around a prescribed value, which might suggest that these values are not completely chaotic. This suggests that there is certain authoritative order structuring the world. Such an authoritative order sets the rules, and consequently the order of the world. Such rules may be taken to stand behind the ordered nature, preserving the indeterminacy of nature from turning into complete chaos. Physical laws of quantum mechanics are an approximate description of such rules. Indeterminacy of the world is an observed fact. For this reason, we consider it as a law of nature rather than being a law of physics. Perhaps we are still in need to explain this natural indeterminacy, but certainly whatever explanation we might find, it shouldn't alter the facts of nature.